Lake Mead is the largest reservoir in America, but shockingly, it faced a major crisis in 2022 when the water levels dropped significantly. This came as a huge surprise, as everyone thought the lake's water supply was endless. But thanks to unforeseen changes in circumstances, Lake Mead started to get full again. But what exactly happened? This is how Lake Mead went from empty to full. What is Lake Mead and why is it so important? The Hoover Dam, which was completed in 1935, is the reason Lake Mead exists. The lake's located along the Colorado River and it stretches all the way to the Nevada-Arizona border. When the lake's full, the water can stretch as far as 247 square miles. But that's not the most amazing aspect of the lake. Would you believe that the lake can also hold 9.5 trillion gallons of water? Of course, its long stretch and ability to hold such huge quantities of water made it a crucial source of water for cities like LA, Las Vegas, and Phoenix. Through these cities, Lake Mead provided water for as many as 25 million people, which makes it one of the most important lakes in the United States. But besides the provision of potable water, Lake Mead also serves the farmers in the area, as it provides more than enough for irrigation purposes, especially around the Californian and Arizona areas. And it doesn't stop there, as Lake Mead is also a major source of electrical power. The lake's water, which powers the Hoover Dam's hydroelectric plant, generates electricity for more than 1.3 million people in the region. Practically, Lake Mead has been a blessing in terms of providing potable water, agricultural purposes, and the generation of electricity. But there's another industry that's benefited greatly from the lake, and that's the tourism industry. Each year, millions of people come from all across the U.S. to catch a glimpse of the Great Lake. And these tourists didn't come to just take pictures of the lake, as there are many recreational activities that can be done there, including fishing, camping, and boating. Now, Lake Mead doesn't just serve the American people alone. This is because it's part of the International Colorado River system, which is shared with Mexico. With this in mind, how did the water levels in the once great Lake Mead drop to record lows? The fall. How did Lake Mead reach critically low levels? The early 2000s marked the beginning of Lake Mead's decline. This decline could be blamed on factors such as the growing water demand due to an increase in population, gradual climate change, and extreme drought. The Colorado Basin, which is responsible for feeding the reservoir, experienced one of its worst droughts in most recent history. There was a lot less rainfall in the early 2000s, and to make matters worse, snowmelts from the Rockies also reduced drastically. Fast forward to 2022, and Lake Mead was almost a thing of the past. This is because its water levels during this year fell to an alarming 170 feet. And by July of the same year, the reservoir's capacity had dropped to as low as 28%. To shed more light on how drastic this drop in water level was, Lake Mead fell to 1,040 feet above sea level. This is the lowest the lake has gone since the 1930s. But if you still don't understand how bad this drop was, then let me elaborate further. Lake Mead's decline in water levels was so bad that intake pipes, old shipwrecks, and even dead humans from decades ago were exposed. And as if that wasn't bad enough, the drop in water also led to the exposure of the bathtub ring along the rocky walls of the Grand Canyon. This wasn't just a reminder of how much of a crisis Lake Mead was going through, it was also a horrific one. With such a significant drop, the reservoir's ability to generate hydroelectricity was immediately put under threat. It got so bad that after experts examined the situation, it was said that if the lake reached as low as 895 feet, then it would enter a deadpool state. Just in case you have no idea what this would mean, reaching a deadpool state would mean that water from Lake Mead would no longer flow through the Hoover Dam. Besides cutting electricity, such a dangerous drop can also tamper with water supply for the millions of people that depend on it, including those in Mexico. Now, let's take a look at the major factors that caused Lake Mead to almost go empty. Climate change, a major culprit. As you would expect, one of the major reasons for the decline of Lake Mead in the Southwest, temperatures kept rising, and this led to more evaporation from the lake and lesser snowpack in the Rocky Mountains, which feeds the Colorado River. And as the winters got warmer, precipitation began to fall as rain rather than snow. Of course, this limited the much-needed snowmelt in the spring to refill the lake. Scientists who had been studying the lake's decline for years predicted that without immediate action, that the region would continue to battle mega droughts, which are very long seasons of extreme drought. This type of drought is known to last for several decades. Such prolonged droughts caused by changes in climate contributed significantly to Lake Mead becoming a mere shadow of its former self. But the decline of Lake Mead can't be blamed on climate change alone, as there was another major factor involved. Water demand. Too much for the system to handle. The southwestern parts of the U.S. are popular for agriculture. It's a region that has also seen a major spike in population. Thanks to the ever-increasing agricultural demands, as well as an increasing population, a major strain was created in Lake Mead's ability to provide. Simply put, the human factor was significant in draining Lake Mead. Los Angeles, Las Vegas, and other cities around the region depend heavily upon water from the reservoir, and a steady increase in population didn't do the lake any good. To add to that, farmers in Arizona are known for using lots of water from the reservoir to grow their water-dependent crops. A good example of such a crop is alfalfa, which needs a great amount of irrigation. But there's something else you need to know. The Colorado River Compact, which is a 1992 agreement that split the water among seven states, allocated more water than the river could sustainably provide, especially as climate conditions got worse. This unwise allocation put a serious strain on Lake Mead, as the pressure to deliver it to cities where water had been allocated meant that the lake would decline rapidly. Thankfully, Lake Mead would catch a much-needed break, as Lake Mead was on the verge of making a strong comeback. The turning point, how 2023 changed everything. Between late 2022 to early 23, Mother Nature extended a helping hand that no one saw coming. Amazingly, the Colorado River Basin received snowfall that was far above the regular average. The snowfall was so much that snowpack levels rose to more than 140% of the yearly average. As spring came, the snow began to melt. And going by the amount of snowpacks available, the surge of melted snow into the Colorado River was unbelievable. This singular event boosted the river flow significantly into Lake Powell and, of course, Lake Mead. And by mid-2023, the significantly increased runoff caused the water levels on Lake Mead to rise. This was the first time in many years that Lake Mead experienced a rise in water levels. By early 2024, Lake Mead's water level had risen to 1,076 feet, and this marked a major improvement since its greatest low point in 2022. Conservation efforts, a human response to the crisis. The climate may have played a favorable role in the recovery of Lake Mead. However, credit also has to be given to serious conservation efforts. There were agreements on ground among the southwestern states that shifted things in Lake Mead's favor in 2019. Specifically, Arizona, California, and Nevada signed the drought contingency plan, agreeing to significantly reduce their water consumption from the lake anytime there was a drought. Las Vegas depends heavily on Lake Mead, so it came as no surprise when they took a bold step and implemented strict limits in water usage and prohibited non-functional grass lawns. But that's not where it would end, as the farmers in Arizona also started using less water-intensive crops. In fact, some were even paid to leave their fields fallow during winter seasons. The federal government also had part to play in Lake Mead's recovery. Financial incentives that ran into millions of dollars were offered to boost conservation. Farmers who were willing to reduce their use of water were the beneficiaries of these incentives, and it also contributed to the recovery process of the lake. Without a doubt, these human efforts combined helped preserve the water levels on the lake. In fact, the water levels in the lake continued to rise since then, and there has been no signs of it dropping in the future. Infrastructure upgrades, adapting to the new normal. In response to the crisis, the government made significant infrastructure upgrades to ensure the reliability of Lake Mead's water and power supply. New intake pipes were installed deep inside the lake, allowing water to be drawn even at low levels. These pipes made absolutely sure that Las Vegas could continue to get water no matter how low the lake's surface fell. The Hoover Dam also underwent upgrades in its turbines, which made the hydroelectric plant more efficient at producing power even with reduced water flow. These adaptations were crucial in preserving electricity production, as Lake Mead's water levels are still far below full capacity. Is this recovery sustainable? Without a doubt, Lake Mead's recovery in 2024 is encouraging. However, experts still warn it may not last that long. The future of the reservoir depends on long-term water management and continued cooperation among the states that rely on the Colorado River. Scientists have cautioned that climate change will certainly bring more extreme weather problems, including longer droughts and shorter periods of heavy precipitation. To prevent more crises in the future, southwestern states have to look for ways to cut down water consumption permanently. This may require stricter conservation policies, investments in water recycling technology, and increased public awareness about the importance of water conservation. A cautious victory, what we've learned. Lake Mead's rise from almost being dried up shows the recovery is possible, but it also serves as a wake-up call that mismanagement of natural resources can be dangerous. Managing water in an area as dry as the southwestern parts of the U.S. requires consistent adaptation. The success of Lake Mead's recovery so far can be credited to a combination of nature's help and human ingenuity. It reminds us that both must work together to sustain the reservoir in the long term. If not, then disaster might loom once more for the lake. Final thoughts. The story of Lake Mead is quite an interesting one. It's a lake that no one thought could be dried up until the early 2000s hit. Thankfully, nature was kind enough to help save the day. Scientists who kept monitoring the lake's water levels and proposing realistic solutions also played a major role. But one of the most important steps taken to get Lake Mead back on track was the strict but helpful conservation efforts that reduced the way water from the lake was being exploited. Thankfully, Lake Mead's back to its glory days. And as long conscious efforts are made to preserve it, it'll be able to serve many future generations to come. Now, head over to the comments and tell us what you think. We're committed to releasing 2 videos a week. Be sure you like, share, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more visionary builds. Thanks for watching.